Today topic is the relative velocity. What is relative velocity? Relative velocity means the velocity of a body, the velocity of a body with respect to the velocity of a body with respect to another body. Velocity of a body with respect to another body is called as relative velocity. Okay, relative velocity. Relative velocity means velocity of one body with respect to another body. For example, VA is the velocity of A body. Velocity of A body. It's not relative velocity. It is the velocity of A body. Velocity of A body. VB is considered as the velocity of B body. Velocity of B body. Then I want relative velocity, means A body velocity when B observes. That is the relative velocity. Relative velocity means velocity of A body with respect to B body. Velocity of A body with respect to B body. What is the meaning of this? When B body observes the A body, when B body observes the A body, then velocity of A body with respect to B body. There is one formula is there. That is velocity of A body minus velocity of B body. This is the formula for the relative velocity. Velocity of A body with respect to B body. The meaning is that, 1 minute I will come. Okay, velocity of A body with respect to B body. That is the relative velocity. Relative velocity means we should compare the velocity of one body with respect to another body. This is the relative velocity. Right? Relative velocity. When B observes the A body, then A body velocity is velocity of A body minus velocity of B body. For example, velocity of B body. You want the velocity of B body with respect to A body. With respect to A body. What is the meaning of this? Velocity of B body when A body observes. Velocity of B body with respect to A body. That is denoted with the VBA. VBA. What I want? I want the velocity of B body with respect to A body. That is VBA bar. Its formula is VB bar minus VA bar. These are the formulas for the relative velocity. Okay? You know here, velocity of A body with respect to B body. Velocity of A body with respect to B body. We got is velocity of A body with respect to B body we got as VA minus VB. Velocity of B body with respect to A body is VB minus VA. Look at here, little disturbance. But once again, I will repeat. We are discussing the relative velocity concept. Relative velocity means velocity of a body with respect to another body. Velocity of one body with respect to another body is called as a relative velocity. For example, I am considering that the velocity of a body, that is the actual velocity of a body, is va, and actual velocity of b body is vb. But what is relative velocity means a body velocity when b observes, then what is that? That is the velocity of a body with respect to b body is equal to velocity of a body minus velocity of b body. Velocity of b body with respect to a body means vba, that is vb bar minus va bar. That means if a observes, b body velocity is what? If b observes, a body velocity is what? That means if you compare the velocity of one body with respect to another body, then that is said to be relative velocity. Now let us see next concept. From equation 1 and 2, we write one thing. From equation 1 and equation 2, that is the velocity of A body with respect to B body is equal and opposite to velocity of B body and with respect to A body. You see this? That velocity of B body with respect to A body we got as Vb minus Va. We can comment the minus sign at here. When you comment the minus sign, you will get the Va minus Vb, right? You will get the Vab. The difference between the Vab and Vba formula is just opposite sign is there, right? Both are subtraction only. This is the relative velocity. Okay, if you go for the practical application of the relative velocity, for example, this is the one train. Okay, this is the one train. And it is at rest. For example, its actual velocity is zero. Okay. Actual velocity is 0, and this is another train, this another train is going back, right, with some velocity Vb, that is 20 km per hour. Let us consider 20 km per hour. The passenger who is sitting in this train B and observing the A train, right, what is the velocity of A train with respect to B train? That is the Va minus Vb we have to do. Va minus Vb we have to do. But here the velocity of A is 0 and velocity of B is 20, but the 20 is the in opposite direction. That's why we have to take as the minus 20 according to sign convention rules. Then here velocity of A body with respect to B body is Va minus Vb, that is 0 minus minus 20. We will get as 20 km per hour. That means A body, A train not have actual velocity, but when B train, the person who is in the B train, if he observes the A train, then he feels that A train is moving with 20 km per hour speed in forward direction. That means A train not have the actual velocity, but A train has relative velocity. Relative velocity means when you compare the velocity of one body with respect to another body, it will come. For example, if you want the velocity of B body with respect to A body, its formula is Vb minus Va, that is Vb is minus 20 and Va is 0, then minus 20 km per hour. That means when we compare the velocity of one body with respect to another body, okay, and when the passenger who is sitting in the B train and observing the rest train, but he feels that actually his train is moving, but he feels that A train is moving forward. A train is moving forward, right? And because plus 20 we got. And here, when the passenger who is sitting in the A train and observing the B train, and he feels that the B train is moving back with the same velocity, minus 20. Right here, velocity of A body with respect to B body and velocity of B body with respect to A body both are equal, but they are in opposite sign. Right now, you see that one live example. One more I will give you that. For example, your bus. You are in the bus. The bus is in moving. Bus is moving. Okay, bus is moving with some velocity. When you see the surrounding, then how the surrounding appears? Will you say? you are sitting in the bus and you are observing the surrounding. And how the surrounding appears, will you say? Yes. Yes, surrounding appears that they are moving backward. If your bus is moving forward, then the surrounding moves backward. Is it correct? If your bus is moving forward, then the surrounding appears as moving backward. The meaning is that when your bus is going forward with some 50 km per hour, if you observe the trees, right? And if you observe the road, right? And that appears as they are moving in backward direction. Actually, they not have the velocity. The tree and the road not goes backward. Your bus is going forward. But when the passenger who is in the bus, he is observing that surrounding, then for him, it appears that the surrounding is going back. That means surrounding not have the actual velocity, but the surrounding has the velocity of the bus when the passenger who is in the bus observes the surrounding. That means the surrounding has the relative velocity. When we compare with the bus, the surrounding has the velocity, right? And if any other passenger who is at rest, he observes the surrounding, means the surrounding appears at rest. But in the moving bus, if the passenger who is sitting in the moving bus and he is observing the surrounding, then for him, the surrounding appears that it is moving in backward direction. Means surrounding not have the actual velocity, but it has relative velocity. Understood? Okay. Now, how to find out the magnitude? Magnitude of relative velocity. Magnitude of velocities. Magnitudes. I want the velocity of B with respect to A, magnitude. Its formula is that VB square plus VA square minus 2VB VA cos theta. This is the formula for the magnitude of relative velocity. Magnitude of relative velocity. Okay. Either VAB also same formula will be there. Under root of V A square plus V B square minus 2 V A V B cos theta, right? That means magnitudes are equal, values are equal. That means velocity of B with respect to A is equal to velocity of A with respect to B. That means relative velocity magnitudes are equal. While using, note that while using above formulas, while using above formulas, VA and VB must be positive. You take only positive velocities. Okay, that is the one condition. Because we have to use only magnitudes. We have to use only magnitudes. Right? And let us see one more point I am going to explain. That is regarding the subtraction of vectors. Subtraction of vectors. How we can subtract the vectors? Subtraction of vectors. Okay, this is one vector. This is one vector. Right, that is A bar. A bar. And another vector we will take as B bar. Okay, B bar. This is the B bar. I want to find out the A bar minus B bar. Then how we can do? Right? This is A bar and that is a B bar. If you want the A bar minus B bar, you should do like this. For example, if you want the A bar plus B bar, we can find out easily. Addition we know. But here we want the subtraction. And this resultant is the, this is the resultant, but it is the addition. It is the addition. But here you should draw the negative vector of B bar, negative vector of B bar, then negative vector is this side will be there. And that this is the resultant of a bar and minus b bar, because according to parallelogram, if two vectors are represented by two sides, then their resultant will be along the middle, along the diagonal. Then this resultant is the a bar minus b bar. This resultant is the a bar minus b bar. This is a subtraction. That means resultant of a bar and minus b bar. Resultant of a bar and minus b bar is called as what? A bar minus b bar. Okay. And a bar plus b bar, how it will be there? A bar minus b bar, how it will be there? That we discussed now. Here resultant vector is r bar equal to a bar minus b bar. And here if you want the magnitude of the resultant vector, in the subtraction if you want the magnitude formula is, magnitude means value, its formula is under root a square plus b square minus 2ab cos theta. We should do the subtraction it here. This is the magnitude formula. Just according to parallelogram law, we will get this one. Okay. And the resultant making some angle with the x-axis. If you want that angle, then the tan alpha is equal to, we have formula t sin theta by a minus b cos theta, we will get. And here theta is what? Theta is angle between the a bar and b bar. Angle between a bar and b bar. These formula derivations I am not going to explain now. Just you remember in the subtraction. Okay, in the addition, how the formulas will be there? In the addition, how the formulas are there? In addition, we discussed previously, right? A parallelogram law. Okay, in the note, you note that also, that if you want the addition of vectors, in addition of vectors, r bar is equal to, we will get as a bar plus b bar. Its magnitude we write as r is equal to under root of a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta, you will get, where theta is angle between the a bar and b bar. Theta is angle between a bar and b bar. Okay, right. Next, one concept I am going to explain, that is very important concept, that is the rain umbrella concept. Rain umbrella concept I am going to explain. Listen very carefully. For example, the rain is falling vertically downward. This is the direction of the rain. One man is running in the rain, right, with some velocity vm, and while running, rain, velocity of rain vr is the velocity of rain which is falling vertically downward. Actually it is falling vertically downward direction. Okay. And Vm is the velocity of man who is running forward. Velocity of man. And here, when this man observes the rain, then how it appears? How it appears? That is called, said to be velocity of rain. Actual velocity of rain is Vr. Actual velocity of man is Vm. But when man observes the rain, then how it appears, and how he has to hold the umbrella. For example, you are going in the you are going with some velocity, and you are going on the bike, right? And at that moment, how you will hold the umbrella, right? In which direction you are going, in that direction you will bend the umbrella. Is it correct, students? Is it correct? You are going in on bike. You are going on bike and the rain is falling vertically downward. But how you will hold the umbrella? You should bend the umbrella. Is it correct? When you will go, when you are going on the bike, right? You should bend the umbrella in a direction, that is in which direction you are going, on the direction you should bend. Is it correct? That means here velocity of rain with respect to man we should do. We have to find out the relative velocity concept it here. Just we I would draw the velocity of man opposite vector at here. This is the velocity of man, Vm it is. Vr minus Vm gives the relative velocity. This is, for example, according to the triangle of vectors, this is one vector and this is A bar and this is B bar. Then the closing side indicates the R bar equal to A bar plus B bar, right? According to that formula, right? The closing side indicates the, here the closing side indicates the velocity of rain with respect to man. Velocity of rain with respect to man it will shows. That means when man shows, running man shows, the rain appears to be fall like this, right? It will fall on his face when the man is running, or when the man is going on bike. At that moment, the rain appears to be falling on his face. Is it correct? When the man is running with some velocity, the rain appears to be fall on his face. Then when the rain is falling on his face, then how he has to hold the umbrella? He has to, generally, when he stand, if the person is standing, right, then he has to hold the umbrella like this. Is it correct? But when he runs or when he is moving on the bike, then how he has to hold the umbrella? For example, this fellow, the same fellow is running forward, or he is moving on the bike with some speed, right? At that moment, he has to bend the umbrella like this and he has to hold the umbrella. Is it correct? Like this he has to bend when he going forward. But here also the rain is falling vertically downward. In this case, the rain is falling vertically downward. But in this case also rain is falling vertical downward, but due to the motion of the person, the rain appears to be falling on his face. That's why he will bend the umbrella. When you are going on the bike, then at that moment the rain falls on his face, but right, and raindrops falls on his face to protect from that, then we should bend the umbrella. At what angle we have to bend, that we want. When the man is running or he is moving on the bike, he should hold the umbrella, right, in such a way that he should make some angle with the vertical. What angle? At what angle he has to hold with the vertical? This is the vertical. This is the vertical, right? And he is, given that this angle is theta and this angle is also theta, then we have to find out the tan theta, right? When the man is running, at that moment the umbrella should made with certain angle, that is angle made by the umbrella with vertical. He has to hold the umbrella with certain angle. That angle we want, that is tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side we have to take, that is Vm by Vr. I want the velocity of rain with respect to man. Velocity of rain with respect to man I want. Velocity of rain with respect to man. That means when man sees the rain, how it appears? How it appears? Right? Velocity of rain with respect to man I want. Then for the purpose, we have to use the vector notation also. That is velocity of rain with respect to man formula. Vr bar minus Vm bar. If you want to find out its magnitude, right? If you want to find out the magnitude, or you can also write in vector form, because you know vectors, this is the positive x-axis, positive y-axis, and the negative y-axis, and negative x-axis. velocity of rain is along the velocity of rain is along the negative y axis minus vr j cap we can write minus velocity of man is along negative x axis we write as minus vm I cap we write because negative x axis means I cap we should write. What I did it here, velocity of rain I wrote as minus vr j cap. Why? Because velocity of rain downward, vertically downward towards negative y axis. Negative y axis means minus j cap. And velocity of man is towards negative x axis. Velocity of man vm bar I wrote as minus vm I cap, negative x axis. Then the total velocity, relative velocity, what you will get? Minus vr j cap plus vm I cap. This is the in vector form. If you want to find out its magnitude, then magnitude of velocity of rain with respect to man. Magnitude of velocity of rain with respect to man. The magnitude we will get as Vrm, that is equal to under root of Vr square plus Vm square. We know very well the magnitude, right? Here you see the actually the rain is falling vertically downward, but due to the running of the person, when the person is running forward, then how the rain appears? Rain appears in such a way that it is falling on his face. That is velocity of rain with respect to man. Actually the rain is falling downward and the man is going forward, but when man sees the rain, it appears to be falling in certain direction, right? And if you want to find out the velocity of rain with respect to man, you see its direction also we can find out. Velocity of rain with respect to man direction is what? This is plus plus, this is minus plus, because x plus positive, this is positive, positive, this is negative, positive, right? Here this is quadrant negative, negative, this quadrant is positive, negative, x comma y, x comma y, x positive, y comma positive, x comma y in this quadrant, x negative, y positive, in this third quadrant, x negative, y negative, in the fourth quadrant, y x positive, y negative, right? And you see this minus plus we got. Minus plus means in which quadrant you will get? Plus minus we got. First we velocity of man is there. On x axis velocity of man is there. Right? Plus minus means anything mistake we did? Velocity of rain is vertically downward. Velocity of man is forward. Oh, we should take plus sign at here. We should take plus sign at here because actually the man is going forward, na? Actually the man is going forward. Man is not going backward. Man is going along positive x axis. That's why we should take plus sign at here. Then here we will get as minus. Then here we got minus minus. Minus minus indicates, minus minus indicates this is the direction of the velocity of rain with respect to man, Vrm. This is the direction. This is the direction, right? Velocity of rain with respect to man. Okay. Once again, I will repeat. It was very simple concept. Rain is actually falling down. Man is running forward. And when this running man observes the rain, then rain direction changes. Actually, the rain is falling down. Man is running forward. But this is the VR. We wrote minus negative vector for the man. That is opposite direction. This is VR. This is minus VM. Their resultant, in the subtraction, we will get the relative velocity. That's why Vr minus Vm, this is the direction of the velocity of rain with respect to man. That means when actually the rain is falling down, But when the running man observes the rain falls along this direction. Rain in which direction it is falling, on that direction he has to hold the umbrella. That's why he has to bend the umbrella in such a way that in which direction he is going, on that direction he has to bend. Then according to mathematics, this angle and this angle is are equal. And when the angles are, both of them are equal, this angle and this angle, then from the figure we write tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side, that with what angle he has to hold the umbrella without without follow the raindrops on his face or on his body. If he don't want to wet, he has to hold the umbrella like this, because the rain appears to be fall like this, right? And next, relative velocity of rain with respect to man, ye kya hai? If the rain observed by the man, then how it will falls? That is the relative velocity. Its formula is vr minus vm. Then here we write the vr minus vm in vector form. We wrote how we wrote vr is the velocity of rain downward it is falling, that's well minus vr j cap, and the way man is going forward, that's well plus vm j I cap. Here vr in place of vr bar, I wrote the vr bar formula. This one we wrote like this, listen very carefully. In place of vr bar, we wrote minus vr j cap, because velocity of rain is negative y axis. J cap indicate y axis, minus j cap indicate negative y axis. Vm, velocity of man, it is the plus vm I cap, because man is going forward. Man is going forward. And after writing in the vector form, then we find out the magnitude. The magnitude of velocity of rain with respect to man is this one, right? Next topic, one more topic I am going to explain. That is uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion. What is uniform circular motion? What is uniform circular motion? Uniform circular motion means, in circular motion, if speed is constant, then that is said to be uniform circular motion. In circular motion, if speed of a body is constant, then that circular motion is called as uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion means the speed should be remains constant. Speed should be remains constant, right? Then this is the, let us see the circular motion now. Let us start it. For example, this is a circle. This is a circle. One object is moving along the circle. One object is moving along the circle, right? And it is going with the constant speed. It is going with the constant speed. At every location, its speed is the same. Right? That means this circular motion is said to be uniform circular motion. If r is the radius of the circle, r is considered as the radius of circle. To move any object in the circular motion, there should be some acceleration is required and there should be some force is required. What is that force which maintains the object in circular path? Anyone knows? Centripetal force means that force acts towards the center, and centripetal acceleration also acts. centripetal acceleration formula is that acts toward the center. Object is going with a constant speed even though it has the acceleration because of change in velocity, direction. Because of change in direction. Centripetal acceleration formula is V square by R. Centripetal acceleration formula is V square by R. V is the speed of object which is going in circular path and R is the radius of circle and centripetal acceleration formula is this one, centripetal acceleration. Okay, and next this we can also change in another format. Okay, right, there is one relation before going to discuss like that. First I am going to explain some other points also. Centripetal force also required to maintain any body in the circular path. Centripetal force means what? Center seeking force. Center seeking force means the force which acts toward the center of the circuit. Mass into acceleration is V square by R. This is the formula for the centripetal force. Centripetal force. Next, few definitions I will give. Angular displacement. Angular displacement. What is angular displacement? What is angular displacement? When a body moving in the circular path, when a body moves in the circular path with some velocity, when a body moves with some velocity in the circular path, the line joining the center and the body is said to be position vector. And when the object goes from this location to this location, this radius vector rotates by some angle, right? That is said to be angular displacement. How much angle it is rotating? That is the angle swept by the radius vector. Angle swept by radius vector. How much angle the radius vector is covering? Okay, and its unit, SI unit, it should be measured in the radians. It should be measured in radians. 180 degree is equal to, you remember, it is the pi radians. And 360 degree equal to 2 pi radians. Angular displacement will be measured in radians. Okay, for example, in one rotation, how much angular displacement is there? Right, one rotation in one revolution, in one complete rotation, how much angular displacement is there? How much angular displacement is there? That is, angular displacement is in one rotation 360 degree it will rotate, 360 degree equal to 2 pi radians. In one rotation, angular displacement is 2 pi radians. In half rotation, how much angular displacement is there? Very good. In half rotations, pi radians will be there. That is said to be angular displacement. Angular displacement means how much angle object rotates. How much angle object rotates. In one rotation, it will rotate. It will take 360 degree angle. But we should not give that unit as degree. In the angular displacement, we should give that unit that is in radians. That's why we have to write like this. And the next one is the angular velocity. Angular velocity. What is angular velocity? In the circular motion, angular velocity is denoted with the omega. This is the angular displacement by time. Angular velocity is the rate of change of angular displacement. Rate of change of angular displacement is called as angular velocity, is called as angular velocity. Because in rotatory motion displacement become angular displacement, circular motion displacement become angular displacement, velocity become angular velocity, acceleration become angular acceleration, because in circular motion, right? In circular motion, other terms we should use. The rate of change of angular displacement is called as angular velocity. What is angular velocity? Omega is equal to angular displacement by time. Angular displacement by time. What is angular displacement? D theta. Time dt. Its unit is radian per second. Okay. And if in terms of time period, angular velocity we write. Angular velocity, there are so many formulas are there. Right? For example, angular velocity for n rotations, how much angular displacement is there? 2 pi n, is it correct? For one rotation, how much angular displacement? 2 pi radians. For n rotations, how much? For one rotation, 360 degree. 360 degree means 2 pi radians. For n rotations, how much it will be there? N into 2 pi, is it correct? Angular displacement? For one chocolate, 10 rupees. 10 chocolates, how much? 10 into 10, we should write. 2 pi n by t. N is the number of rotations. Number of rotations are the revolutions. Okay. Or otherwise, we can also write like this. Omega is equal to 2 pi is the for one rotation. In one rotation, angular displacement is 2 pi. Angular displacement d theta we write as 2 pi. But for one rotation, time taken in the denominator is the time period. 2 pi by t also we write. T is the time period. Time period means what, you know? Time for one rotation. Time I am taking one rotation. If time is one rotation. Okay, if time is one rotation. If time is one rotation. One rotation means one time taken for one rotation is the time period. In that time, angular displacement how much? 2 pi radians. Right? Next, this. Two pi by t, reciprocal of time period is said to be frequency, that you learn in the 9th class. Nu is the frequency. There are so many formulas are there for the angular velocity. Okay, right. Next one is angular acceleration. What is angular acceleration? Angular acceleration. Angular acceleration, that is alpha. Angular acceleration is alpha. It is the rate of change of angular velocity. The rate of change of angular velocity. Rate of change of angular velocity is called as angular acceleration. Angular acceleration. Angular acceleration formula is rate of change of angular velocity, that is d omega by dt. D omega by dt. D by dt means rate of change of, omega means angular velocity, where omega is angular velocity. Angular velocity. Its unit is radian per second square. Radian per second square. Okay. And some relations we want. In the rotatory motion, in circular motion, we use the angular displacement, angular velocity, angular acceleration. I want the relation between the linear velocity and angular velocity. Relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. Linear velocity what? Velocity along a straight line. Angular velocity means what? Velocity in rotatory motion. Okay. There is one relation is there. You remember directly. That is V is equal to R omega. V is equal to R omega. Next. Relation between linear acceleration and angular acceleration. Relation between the A and alpha. A what? A is the linear acceleration. Alpha is angular acceleration. Relation between them is A is equal to R alpha. Okay. And here we have some node point I am going to give. That is the centripetal acceleration formula is what? Centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration means center seeking acceleration, acceleration which acts toward the center of the circle. Its formula is v square by r. But we write v is equal to r omega whole square by r, then r square omega square. That means centripetal acceleration formula, one is v square by r, other is r omega square. You remember both of them. Okay, right. And this is the thing. Okay, once again you can watch to get the clear concept. Okay, once again you can watch these videos. Little bit fast I explain it because of time management. We have to complete more 4 chapters, right? Okay, I am going to stop.